The astonishing oyster leaf plant can be found on the cold and rocky shores of Northern Europe, and increasingly on plates in some of the world's most innovative restaurants. This striking maritime perennial with its thick greenish-gray leaves and blue bell-shaped flowers holds a botanical secret. Bite into one of the succulent leaves and behold the unmistakable briny, shiny flavor of oysters. Scientists have traced this plant's oyster-like flavor to the presence of four volatile compounds. Oyster leaf, Mertensia maritima, is a member of the borage family. Very much a cold climate plant, it grows wild on the sand and shingle beaches of Scotland, Northern Ireland, Iceland, Greenland, Northern Canada, and Northern New England, though changing climate conditions have pushed its growing range farther north. Other pressures, such as grazing and human encroachment, have endangered it as well. So foragers rejoice when they find patches of the low-growing plant persisting in such inhospitable conditions. In summer, the small reddish flowers turn to blue as they mature, in the same way that forget-me-nots and other members of the borage family do. Its long taproot anchors it to the wave and wind-swept beaches. Its roots, leaves, and flowers are all edible. English botanist Jeremy Bartlett notes that when conditions are right, colonies of the oysterleaf plant can live for hundreds of years, and its adaptation to harsh subarctic conditions is remarkable. Bartlett says that the nutlets or seeds of the oysterleaf plant have been known to spread almost 300 miles by wind or sea. The seeds are capable of lying dormant for several years until conditions are right, and they can germinate after more than 2 weeks immersed in seawater. Oyster leaf plant goes by many names: seaside bluebells, northern shorewort, sea lungwort, ice plant, and vegetarian oyster. Its genus is named for the German botanist Franz Carl Mertens and also includes species such as Mertensia ciliata, or fringed bluebells, and Mertensia virginica, or Virginia bluebells. Along with foods such as marsh marigold and wild lettuce, oyster leaf was an important food source for the Inuit and Yupik people of Alaska, who ate the roots and leaves perhaps as a means of preventing scurvy. It's still a part of their cuisine, sometimes boiled briefly and served with seal oil. Fortunately, it's also possible to cultivate oyster leaf plants in the garden, and thanks in part to adventuresome chefs, it's emerging from obscurity. Keep things simple when eating oyster leaf for the first time so that you can marvel at the sea-washed flavor of these thick, tender leaves. Oyster leaf plants like sandy or loamy soil, and they can tolerate poor soil, but not shade. Sow the seeds in fall or in very early spring, or place them in the refrigerator for several weeks before germinating them at 65 to 70 degrees Fahrenheit. Be patient. Germination can take a month or more, and it may be erratic. Once it gets going, though, oyster leaf plant is beautiful and hardy, and some gardeners say they never want to be without it.
Thanks so much for watching Seed Stories. We love bringing you the backstory on these amazing varieties. Be sure to click the subscribe button so you won't miss a single episode.